go. Let's go. Okay, I'm very, very shy. I was like doing this normally before I started recording. And the minute I started recording, I got fucking weird. I mean, anyways, hi guys, I'm Violet. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time clicking on this video, thank you so much. Whether you came from WhatsApp or Instagram, or I don't know where you found this video, but thank you so much for clicking on it. It means a lot to me. Please subscribe if you haven't already, because you can see the vibes. Please, I'm begging you, please, please. Anyway, child, this was supposed to be part two of me job shadowing a neurosurgeon. Well, if you didn't watch my previous video, it was me job shadowing a neurosurgeon over my December holiday. But I decided to not post vlog two, week two. I decided not to post the second vlog because I ended up only shadowing for a week and 2 days, like on the Tuesday. I ended up only shadowing 2 days in the second week, so I was like, that's not enough content to provide for you guys. And I also didn't vlog so much, and I wasn't really satisfied with the content that I did vlog. So Tuesday was basically my last day. We had to end early because, that you know, December, the Omicron variant was doing a lot, and like, the doctor I was shadowing is not from this country, so he needed to leave the country before the ban was like extended. In fact, there was a ban on Namibia and certain countries from entering other countries, but he needed to leave, so he needed to leave as soon as possible so he can go somewhere else and have enough time to quarantine there and go to the country that he wanted to go to. So yeah, we ended up ending on Tuesday, but the Tuesday was a really nice day. It was the last day, and it was a theater day, because you know, hope for theater. We ended up removing a brain tumor. I think I'll insert the pic of the brain tumor that we removed, scan version obviously. Yeah, it was a really, really, really exciting procedure, but it was so long. It was so nice to experience like how they actually take out a tumor inside your cranium, because it seems almost like virtually impossible, but it's possible. He did it. It was like, was it 11 hours? I think it was 10 hours. And because my lactose intolerance likes to play me, I felt like, okay, it might be TMI for you too. Let's just say I ended up almost passing out, and I had to unscrub and go take a pause. I think I went to pause for like an hour and then scrub back in and continued assisting the doctor. But yeah, it was really insightful. It was really so interesting to see how they remove brain tumors. Like, wow. Yeah, I don't think my brain will ever fathom like how amazing it actually is, because it's such a small confined space, and any little mistake, you can change who someone is for the rest of their lives. And he's like, he's so good at his job. So it was so amazing. That was a good last day, perfect last day. And yeah, overall, in general, the experience was really, 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 really nice. Absolutely worth it, and I wish I could do more. And I remember in my previous video, I mentioned that I was going to say why I decided to do an elective neurosurgery. Well, if you guys don't already know, I was going to say mildly obsessed. I'm like extremely obsessed with surgery. And ever since I was a kid, it has always been, okay, I've danced around a lot of specialties, but I knew at the core of my soul that the brain was the most interesting to me. So that was always what I wanted to pursue. So yeah, in med school I decided to make that dream happen and like go explore and like put myself in that situation to see if I'd actually like to do something like that with my, like, the rest of my life. So that's why I decided to do it, so I can get a taste of what my future will be like and see if I can do it and if I even want to. And so far we're definitely still on that path. Need to normalize making eye contact. It's so weird for me in person, even I can't make this much eye contact. So yeah, peaks and the pits for that experience. The peak was just the entire experience, just breathing the same air as the neurosurgeon was my peak for me. Definitely my peak. Pit was that I didn't get to do it as long as I wanted to. When I say peaks and pits, I mean like the best parts and the worst parts. The pits was OPD days were low-key kind of boring. I won't even lie to you. Basically, please subscribe, please like, because this year, I'm dedicating this year to content creation. It's my final year of medical school, and I want you guys to experience this lost journey with me, you know? Also, I want to have the memories for the rest of my life, so I'm going to try to vlog as many experiences as I can as a student before I'm out of here and get that degree and get that money. Anyways, I'm trying to get monetized. Also, we're really close to 1,000K. So we're really close to 1,000K. I just need the watch time hours, so I'm gonna need you guys to go watch all my videos, okay? And please watch till the end and like and leave a comment. Just interact with the video, please. I'm literally begging you. Let me know in the comments right now what kind of med school related content y'all would like to see. I'm obviously gonna be doing some other stuff as well to attract people who are not into medicine, because you know, I just need the subscribers, please, man. And the views. Brain is a little bit scattered because I just came from my first day of rotations. I'm starting in pediatrics. And it was a little bit underwhelming, but I just feel tired. I'm ready for my afternoon nap. But I decided what to do is before I change out of my work clothes, because if I don't do this today, I'll never do it again. Yeah. Happy 2022, and I hope wherever you find yourself in the world, you're having a good time, and then this is your year. You know how we don't claim years anymore because the pandemic has humbled us, but I genuinely hope that you try and make the best out of your year. Yeah. I think that's it. That's literally it. That's it. Go follow me on Instagram. I'm pretty funny there, and you will see like the real authentic version of me. Okay, WhatsApp sees that, but you know, Instagram gets like pretty second best. And what you would like to see on this YouTube channel, I'm ready to show you guys any and everything. You know what I'm saying? Yay, Mara! I don't know if I'm gonna post this. I didn't record this shit for nothing, so I'm gonna put it on YouTube. Yes, another thing I wanted to talk about is that I have so much unedited content that I will have to release to you guys in due time. I will. It's also like med school related and travel vibes almost. But I have this thing of where I actively vlog, and then I go watch the content and I'm like, I don't like it. I don't want to put it on YouTube. But I'm just like, you never know. Someone might fucks with the content that you put out there. So my goal this year will just to put everything out there. It's fine. People must decide whether they like it or not. Someone's gonna watch it. It's gonna appeal to somebody. Yeah. I'm not really a perfectionist, but sometimes I just feel like the content must be worth it, man. Like now, I'm having second thoughts about this video right now, but I didn't speak for 10 minutes for nothing, so y'all gonna have to see it. Anyways, like and subscribe, and please watch all the videos. Go catch up, get to know me when I was a boo, because, you know, one day I'm not gonna be this boo, you know?